I'm Kim, the Abundant Traveler, and this is everything you need to know before you head to Nice, France. Welcome back to the channel, and if you're new here, I put out weekly laid-back luxury travel videos inspiring you to buy that plane ticket and get out there and go. Today, I'm going to be talking a little bit about the things that you need to know before you head to Nice on the French Riviera or the Côte d'Azur in southern France. First and foremost, Nice is a large city. It has an international airport. There are tons of people here. I believe the population is around 300,000 people. So my suggestion is come jet lag here, spend a few days here, and then get off the beaten path and go see some of the smaller villages like Antibes, Villefranche, Menton, and the other places that are absolutely spectacular. I love Nice. I actually lived here in my 20s for an entire summer. I was studying French. I just love this city, but the best thing to do is get off the beaten path. Since France is part of the European Union, you will be spending euros while you're here. It's about 15 euros for a Niçoise salad, and maybe it's 2 euros for a coffee in the morning. So I would say the prices are relatively normal, even for such a popular destination for tourists. And speaking of summer, you might want to be careful about coming to Nice in August. In August, the entire country of France is on vacation, and so you will see all of the hotel prices, the restaurant prices are much higher than they are the rest of the year. Additionally, it's hard to get into great hotels, Airbnbs, restaurants are full, so you might want to consider coming to Nice at a different time of the year. To me, the most important thing to note is the fact that the beaches are rocks. The beaches are not beautiful sand beaches like you have in different parts of the world. You definitely have to bring water shoes while you're here. It is very difficult to get in and out of the Mediterranean here. If you don't like all the rocks on the beach, I love laying on the ground. I love the heat. I love the earth under me. But you can go to one of the beach clubs and rent a chair, umbrella, be served cocktails all day at one of the beach clubs. A chair here in Nice at Opera Plage or Beau Rivage is around 22 euros for the day. You have to pay extra for entry and extra for an umbrella. But some days it's worth it if you're here on a true vacation and not just touring and visiting around. If you're actually looking for a more active vacation, then you might want to consider getting the French Riviera Pass. It's around 50 euros for 2 days, and you get access to several museums, you get access to the double-decker bus, the little train that goes around the city. We could have gone to the Chagall Museum, the Matisse Museum. It also gets you into other events along the French Riviera, including the Oceanographic Museum in Monte Carlo and the fort over in Antibes. So if you're going to see the entire Riviera, might be a good idea to get the French Riviera Pass. Since Nice is such a large city and it's so walkable, I do not recommend getting a car while you're here. If you're going to go up into Provence, perhaps you can rent a car just for the day, and I'd recommend getting it on the outskirts of town, not picking up a car in the center of town where you have to work your way through all of the one-way streets. So while you're here, I definitely recommend that you stay near Vieux-Ville, or the Old Town of Nice. That's where all of the great restaurants are, the little tiny streets, the most beautiful places to take photographs, and it's also where Nice is happening after dark. And speaking of after dark, dinner here in Nice is around 8:30 at night. You will find people, they go in from the beach around 5 p.m. and then they change clothes, they get ready, and then they go out for a cocktail. So you'll see what's interesting are the cocktail bars are really, really full where everybody's sitting outside. And they sit outside and have a drink. An Aperol Spritz is a great thing to have while you're here. And then around 8:30, you migrate from the cocktail lounge over to your restaurant. Here, I definitely recommend a couple of traditional things. The salad niçoise, of course, and the salad niçoise is a relatively new thing in Nice. There is also a dish called soca, which is a chickpea flour. It looks like a pizza crust, and it's served. It is actually only chickpea flour, water, salt, and pepper, and they serve it in the middle of the day, typically, and you just have pepper on it, and it's a great little snack to have. It's usually about 3 euros for an entire plate. So those are a couple of things you definitely want to try. As far as cocktails while you're here, the drinks you want to have are the Provence red, white, and rosé wines. Personally, I have had nothing but Provençal rosé my entire time here, and about 5 o'clock in the afternoon, I tend to have an Aperol Spritz. So if you're traveling to Nice, the best things to pack are walking shoes. This town is extremely walkable. The Promenade des Anglais is actually 4 miles long, and so there's plenty of places to walk. I brought my Birkenstocks, I brought my flip-flops just to go to the beach. Also, the city is quite casual. It's a little more sophisticated than you see on, say, Panama City Beach, Florida, but in general, it's relatively casual. I've been wearing nice shorts, some nice, just casual shoes in the evening, brush my hair, but don't fix my hair, a little bit of makeup, just probably a little bit of mascara, and just nice, comfortable clothes. Again, it's hot here, it's the middle of summer, it is the beach, and it's quite humid, if you can't tell by this mess. If you're gonna come in the middle of summer and you are booking your accommodation, if you're looking at Airbnb or a hotel, it doesn't matter. Something you might wanna consider is looking specifically for a hotel or Airbnb that has air conditioning. Like most of Europe, it is quite uncommon to have air conditioning in your accommodation. So if you're from the US and you're used to being 68 degrees when you sleep at night, I'd recommend you ask for AC. And of course, if you don't get AC in your room, then you can definitely go swimming all day and all night in the Med. The Med in general is a little bit colder water. It's not like what we're used to in the Caribbean. It's a little deeper, the blues are gorgeous, and it's just a little bit cooler. It's also quite salty. My favorite place to swim in the entire world is in the Mediterranean. It is my happy place. I just love being on the Med. Give me Austin, Texas, give me the Med, and I'm a happy girl. Who's going with me? Something else that's quite easy when you're traveling to Nice, since it's such a large city, credit cards are widely accepted. I just suggest getting a few euros once you land at the airport at an ATM, and then the rest of the time, you can basically purchase everything with your credit card. Just remember to put on a travel alert when you're headed out of the country, so your credit cards and your ATMs are actually usable when you're over here. So if you've been to Nice and you have any tips, make sure to leave them in the comments below. I'll add them to my blog on my website and definitely share them with my travel tribe on my Tuesday emails. And if you'd like to get weekly tips, tricks, and updates in your email, make sure to go to the description below and sign up for my travel tribe. Again, I'm Kim, the Abundant Traveler, and I'll see you on the next adventure. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to stay tuned next week for my top things to do while you're visiting Nice. I do recommend while you're staying here to go, In all reality, first and foremost, Nice is, I don't know what else to say there. So if you've been to Nice and you have any tips, I'd love to hear what you think in the, that's the description. Oops.